हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल माय सेल्फ राकेश एवले। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन GPRS एंड मोबाइल डेटा कम्युनिकेशन। वेटेज फॉर दिस यूनिट इज 12 मार्क्स। इन दिस यूनिट फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स आर कवर्ड: GPRS आर्किटेक्चर, GPRS सर्विसेज, GPRS नेटवर्क नोड्स, वायरलेस लैन RFID, 802.11 स्टैंडर्ड प्रोटोकॉल, ब्लूटूथ, वाईफाई, वाईमैक्स एंड मोबाइल IP। जनरल पैकेट रेडियो सिस्टम, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज GPRS। इट इज अ थर्ड जनरेशन स्टेप टूवर्ड्स इंटरनेट एक्सेस। GPRS is also known as GSM IP, that is Global System Mobile Communication Internet Protocol, as it keeps the user of this system online, which allows to make a voice call and internet on the go. Even time division multiple access TDMA user benefit from this system, as it provides packet radio access. GPRS also permits the network operators to execute an internet protocol based core architecture for integrated voice and data application that will continue to used and expand for 3G services. Following are the key features that describes the wireless packet data. First, the always online feature. It removes the dial-up process, making application only one click away. Second, an upgrade to existing system. Operators do not have to replace their equipment, rather GPRS is added on top of the existing infrastructure. Third, an integral part of future 3G system. GPRS is the packet data core network for 3G system, Edge and WCDMA. This diagram shows the architecture of GPRS system. In this diagram, various components are there: HLR, VLR, EIR, AUC. Along with these components, GGSN and HGSN, these are the two new components introduced in this architecture. GPRS architecture works on same procedure like GSM network, but has additional entities that allows packet data transmission. This data network overlaps a second generation GSM network, providing packet data transport at the rates from 9.6 to 171 kbps. Along with the packet data transport, the GSM network allows multiple user to share the same air interface resources concurrently. GPRS is usually attempts to reuse the existing GSM network elements as much as possible. There are new entities called as GPRS support nodes, GSN, which are the responsible for delivery and routing of the data packets between the mobile station and external packet networks. These two components are serving GPRS server support node SGNS and gateway GPRS support node GGNS. Applications of GPRS. First, mobility. The ability to maintain constant voice and data communication while on the move. Second, immediacy. It allows subscriber to obtain connectivity when needed, regardless of location and without a lengthy login session. Third, localization. It allows subscriber to obtain information relevant to their current location. Fourth, still image. It allows to take the photographs, pictures, postcard, greeting cards and presentation, static web page that can be sent and received over the mobile network. Limitations of GPRS. First, limited cell capacity for all users. GPRS does impact a network's existing cell capacity. There are only limited radio resources that can be deployed for different users. Second, the speed obtained in the GPRS network is much more in reality that is mentioned in theoretically. Third, achieving the theoretical maximum GPRS data transmission speed of 172.2 kbps would require a single user taking over all 8 time slots without any error protection. Fourth, transit delay. GPRS packets are sent in all different directions to reach the same destination. This opens up the potential for one or some of those packets to be lost or corrupt during the data transmission over the radio link. GPRS data services. A wide range of corporate and consumer applications are enabled by GPRS services. GPRS service includes all normal GSM services but in more efficient way. It also supports services like email, web browsing, enhanced short message, wireless imaging with instant picture, video service, document and information sharing. A user likely to use either two of modes of the GPRS network. These are application mode and second tunneling mode. GPRS data services. First, application mode. In this mode, user will be using GPRS mobile phone to access applications running on the mobile phone itself. The phone here act as an end user device. All GPRS phone have web browser or embedded application. This browser allows browsing of various websites. Some GPRS device supports mobile execution environment. Second, tunneling mode. This mode is for mobile computing where the user will use the GPRS interface as an access to the network. The end user device will be a large footprint device like laptop computer or small footprint device like PDA. The mobile station MS will be connected to the device and used as modem to access the wireless data network. GPRS bearer service. GPRS is a wireless extension of data networks. It can be accessed to the data networks such as IP-based network, including public internet, private internet, IPv4, IPv6 protocol, and X25-based network. GPRS upgrades data services and provides the following services. Point-to-point service. It allows internet networking with the internet and X.25 networks. Point-to-multipoint service. It allows multicast and point-to-multipoint group calls. SMS service. Anonymous service. Future enhancement like add new functions, like increasing the capacity, increasing the more user access to the new services, new protocols, and new radio networks. GPRS support node. First, serving GPRS support node. It is the same it is placed at same hierarchical level as MSC. Whatever the MSC does for voice, SGSN does the same function for the packet data. SGSN task is to include the packet switching, routing, transfer, mobility management, that is attach and detach and location management, logical link management and authentication and charging function. SGSN processes registration of new mobile subscriber and keeps a record of their location inside the given service area. The location registered of SGSN stores the location information, for example, current cell, current VLR, and user profiles of all GPRS users registered with SGSN. SGSN sends the queries to Home Location Registered (HLR) to obtain the profile data of GPRS subscriber. The SGSN is connected to the base station system with frame relay. Gateway GPRS Support Node (GGSN). It is act as an interface between the GPRS backbone network and external packet data network. GGSN main function is similar to that of router in the local area network. GGSN maintains the routing information that is necessary to tunnel the protocol data units PDU to the SGSN that service particular mobile station. It converts the GPRS packets coming from SGSN into appropriate packet data protocol PDP format for the data networks like internet or X25. PDP sends these packets out on the corresponding packet data network. In other direction, PDP receives incoming data packets from the data networks and converts them. Wireless LAN 802.11. Wireless LAN are those local area networks that use the high frequency radio waves instead of cables for connecting the device in local area network. Users connected by wireless LAN can move around within the area network coverage. Most WLANs are based on IEEE standard 802.11 protocol, or also known as Wi-Fi network. The IEEE 802.11 is a standard set of rules for the wireless area network WLAN, which was implemented in 1997 and was used in the industrial, scientific, and medical field. It is quickly implemented through wide region, but under its standard, the network occasionally receives the interfaces from the devices such as cordless phone, microwave ovens. The main purpose of this protocol is to provide wireless network connection for the fixed, portable, and moving station within 10 to 100 meters with one medium access control and several physical layer specification. This was later known as 802.11a protocol. The major protocols includes the 802.11n. The most significant difference lies in the specification of their physical layer. This is the one simple wireless architecture diagram shown. As you see in this network, there is a one common wireless access point. All the devices in this particular area are connected to this wireless access point with the radio waves. Architecture of 802.11 protocol. It consists of following components, stations, STA. The stations consist of all the devices and equipments that are connected to the wireless LAN. A station can be of the two type, wireless access point, WAP. It is a simple access point are generally wireless routers that are form the base station or access. Client, all the workstation, computers, laptop, printer, smartphone, etc. are known as client. Each station has wireless network interface controller. Base service set BSS, basic service set BSS. A basic service set is a group of station communicating at physical layer level. BSS can be of two categories depending on the mode of operation. Infrastructure BSS. In this, the devices communicates with the other devices through the access point. Independent BSS. Here, devices communicate in peer-to-peer basis in ad hoc manner. Extended service set ESS. It is a set of all connected BSS. Distribution system DS. It connects access point in ESS. Advantages of wireless LAN. It provides free home, office, and other network places. The LAN are scalable in nature. That is, devices can be added or removed from the network at greater ease than the wireless, than the wired network. The system is portable within the network coverage, and access to the network is not bounded by the length of the cable. Installation and setup is much more easier than the wired components. The equipment and the setup cost is reduced. Disadvantages of wireless LAN. Since the radio waves are used for the communication, the signals are noisier with the more interference from the nearby system. Greater care is needed for encrypting the information. Also, they are more prone to errors, so they require greater bandwidth than the wired LAN. Wireless LAN are much more slower than wired LAN network.